Regular programming will not be seen tonight, so that we may bring you the following KJAC special presentation. Tonight, Clay Walker.
Everybody asks, what is it about Beaumont? So that tells me one thing for sure, that Beaumont's on the map.
Tracy Byrd.
I never dreamed that Holding Heaven would be my first number one song, but it took off and just kept climbing the charts and wouldn't stop. Oh, I had a
ball right. And Mark Chestnut.
But it's all over now and it sure isn't Monday.
Be the same old boy that you were when they found you, and try not to let it all go to your head, because it can end a lot quicker than it started.
KJC TV4 and KYKR 95.1 present in simulcast Blame It on Beaumont, a country music year to remember. Brought to you by Beaumont Regional Medical Center, Market Basket, and your hometown GMC truck dealers.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Jimmy Lane, Program Director of KYKR Radio.
And I'm Mark Clegg, News Director for KJC TV4. Tonight we're looking back on the year in country music. It's been a phenomenal year across the country, but especially here in Southeast Texas.
Across the country music radio format continues to be the most popular radio format. Nearly 42% of Americans tune into country radio on a daily basis. Since the country music explosion in 1990, nearly 21 million new adult listeners have become country music fans.
Here in Southeast Texas, country music has seen a big boost based largely on the spotlights shining on three local boys, Mark Chestnut, Tracy Byrd, and Clay Walker. Two of those spotlights originally hung right here at Cutter's, the country music hotspot that gave Mark and Tracy their starts.
All three have gone on to great success in 1993, including number one records, gold albums, and some award recognition.
When we come back, we'll meet these three artists, listen to some of their hit videos, and talk about their career highlights that made 1993 a year to remember.
But I think my lucky stars above, that I got the chance to have a dance. But one dance just ain't enough. I think I'm falling in love.
You like trucks?
Really like trucks?
Sierra by GMC Truck. American-made quality and value.
Texas best.
Rugged, tough trucks that combine comfort and style.
Now that's a truck I'd like.
Standard 4.3-liter V6 that cranks out 160 horsepower and more available engines than any other full-size pickup.
That's real power.
Sierra from GMC. Only at your hometown GMC truck dealers.
I shop at Market Basket because of the prices. I find them to be much lower than any of the other stores that I've shopped at.
Well, I shop at Market Basket because of the low cost of food and vegetables and fruits and stuff, yeah.
Prices at Market Basket are just as good or if not better than anywhere in town.
I love Market Basket because of the triple coupons.
Hey, what have they been doing at the Little Blue Building, East Tex and Lucas?
Oh, that's Starbreak. We've been sprucing up and cleaning.
Why?
Well, so our building will be as good as our brick and front end work.
You do brake and front end work?
Sure we do. We'll give you a free estimate in 10 minutes, show you the problem, tell you the price, do the job in 60 to 90 minutes, even give you a lifetime warranty on your brakes.
That sounds too good to be true.
Yes, but it is. But hey, where are you going?
To Starbreak for one of those lifetime brake jobs.
Starbreak, we'll give you a break.
Y'all stop by.
Tracy Byrd got his first taste of Nashville 27 years ago when he visited the Grand Ole Opry with his parents. Actually, he was 6 months old at the time and doesn't remember very much. But what he does remember is growing up here in Southeast Texas to the sounds of country music. These days, it's the whole country that's listening to the sounds of Tracy Byrd.
I thought Susie would have called by now to tell me all about that wild and crazy LA scene. Well, I know my number's in her book. Why don't the telephone ring?
Tracy Byrd is still reeling in the success of his debut album, but the 27-year-old sounds a lot like a veteran artist at the top of his career. He comes across as a gentleman cowboy, both on stage and off, and it's no wonder his idol is fellow MCA recording artist George Strait. A native of Vitor, Tracy never picked up a guitar until after high school, but after spending $7.95 to record Your Cheating Heart at a mall recording studio, he was hooked. He moved into Beaumont and the vacancy at Cutter's left behind by Mark Chestnut. In 1991, he married Michelle Hilton. With a recording contract in 1992, the rest is country music history.
Look right here, try and get a picture.
Just before Christmas, Tracy returned home to celebrate a part of that history. Old friends once again packed the Beaumont night spot to watch Tracy cut out the table he signed his contract on. The table has been shipped off to Nashville to be a part of a special exhibit in the Country Music Hall of Fame, an early honor for this hot new artist.
Oh, man, it's great. I mean, that table symbolizes, to me anyway, the beginning of my really professional career. You know, I played here at Cutter's for about 3.5 years, four or five nights a week. And, you know, we hashed it out and went through all the hard paying your dues times, I guess is what they'd call it. And I paid them all right here in Southeast Texas. So it's nice to get part of this club, to send up to Nashville and be able to be, this club be recognized as part of my career and part of what made my career.
The table honor is just one of the many accomplishments Tracy racked up in 1993. We sat down to talk about his career, his private life, and his fondness for Beaumont, where it all began at Cutter's. Years from now, when you look back on 1993, what's going to be the real standout, something that you'll really remember?
Oh, man, a lot of the shows stand out to me. You know, some of the things we played, for instance, July the 4th in Phoenix, Arizona comes to mind, and this was early out when we just hit the road, and we played in front of 170,000 people. I mean, it was as far as you could see. It was like Woodstock or something. I wasn't there, but I've seen pictures. That's what it looked like. It was just a sea of people. And things like that stand out, you know, because that's, you know, to go from here at Cutter's to, you know, with 600 people on a packed night to 170,000 people is pretty wild. That's a pretty drastic change. And so it, I had to adjust pretty quick. But among that, you know, that and just, it was just a whirlwind of a year, and it's really hard to remember what all I've done sometimes because it happens so fast and we're in a different town every day. You know, a lot of the TV interviews, a lot of the, you know, Nashville Now and things like that we done really stand out in my memory because of the first times we had done it.
That's the thing about a memory. It's got a mind of its own.
Tracy's Nashville Now performance gave him great exposure on the Nashville network. However, his first single, That's the Thing About a Memory, didn't do as well as he or MCA thought it would. It was just a matter of time, though, before things really took off with his remake of an old Johnny Paycheck song.
Someone to give my love to.
Tracy calls Someone to Give My Love To his signature song, but it was his third single which really took him to the top.
I'm holding heaven in my arms tonight. Everything about you is so perfectly right. I've never been there, but I think I might be holding heaven in my arms tonight.
They could things to do. I mean, I never dreamed that Holding Heaven would be my first number one song, but it took off and just kept climbing the charts and wouldn't stop. And that definitely will be in my memory. You know, I've got a big plaque at home that MCA had made for me and with a Billboard chart, and so I'll be remembering that for a long time to come.
Where were you when you got the news that it had gone number one?
I was in my hotel room in Nashville, and the people from MCA, the promotion people, called me up, and they said, get over here, we got to celebrate. And I said, celebrate what? And they said, we just got the Billboard charts. Said, you went number one this week.
Tracy says his next goal is a gold album, and next month, the fate of another honor will be decided. Tracy is nominated for the American Music Awards Best New Country Artist.
Hey, that was a total surprise, man. I mean, I never dreamed that. I mean, because there's so many other new artists that come out with me, you know, through the last year and a half, and I just really didn't know what to think. Well, I thought it was a hoax at first, you know. I thought, oh, somebody's pulling my leg, you know, they've made a mistake. And but then sure enough, you know, a week later or so, they were calling me up and sending me a letter saying I was nominated by the fans, you know. And that makes it even better, because at first I didn't know who voted on the American Music Awards. And then I got the letter and from Dick Clark, and it said that it was the fans that had voted me in. So that makes it even that much sweeter, because that lets me know that it's happening out, you know, in the public, that they're really liking what I'm doing, and chose me over a lot of other people that they could have put in there. So it was very flattering.
The nomination carries even more competition than most awards. Also nominated is Beaumont's Clay Walker, with John Michael Montgomery rounding out the category. With the names Tracy Byrd, Mark Chestnut, and Clay Walker continually grouped together, Tracy says there's a camaraderie, but it's sometimes bittersweet.
I seen Billy Crystal say something the other night when he was talking about writing and directing Mr. Saturday Night, that movie about stand-up comics that he done. And he said that that comedians are kind of funny, because they can be real good friends with another comedian, and one half of them is really happy for him when he's doing well, and the other half is like, oh man, I want what he's got, I want to get that. So I guess it's that way in music too, you know. I mean, we're competitive on one side, and compassionate and friends on the other, you know, because Mark and I and Clay, all Clay and I went to school, you know, the same high school, and I love to see those guys doing good, you know. But then there's the competitiveness too, you know, and I don't think you can deny it.
It was through his pal Mark Chestnut that Tracy got to know his idol, George Strait.
They had called me to come over there, and it was kind of strange the way my road manager called me and said, come over to the steakhouse. I said, oh man, I'm tired, I'm going to bed. He said, no, please, come on over here. And I said, all right. And so we went over and sat down having a drink, and somebody come up and put their hands over my face, you know, and I was starting feeling, I said, who is this, you know, and turned around, and it was Chestnut. And had his hands on my eyes, and I spun around, and it was Chestnut, and there stood Strait right there, and he's my, you know, I mean, Strait's my hero, and we had met before, you know, a couple of three times, and we're on the same label and everything, all of us, and, but that night was really cool, because, I mean, because he sat down and actually sat there, and for 45 minutes or an hour, you know, and we just talked. Just like the guys, you know. So it was really a lot of fun, and got to know him a lot better, and you know, his personal self, and not just the star that everybody else knows. And he was just a really great guy, and he even tried to sell me a bus through the conversation that night. Got a beating around asking me, do you lease a bus? And I said, yeah. And he said, really? And he said, boy, you know, the best Eagles they ever made was in 1984. And I said, really? Yeah, and he said, I just happen to have an 84 Eagle that I'll sell you. I said, I bet you would. I said, but I'm not in the market for a bus.
Earlier you were saying it's been a whirlwind year for you. How have you changed in the past year?
I hope it hasn't changed me for the worse. I think it's changed me for the better in a few ways. Just that you know, the road is so busy and so demanding and scheduled, and I believe that I've become harder, more focused entertainer, harder working, you know, just because you see what's got to be done. I believe I've, you know, became a little more disciplined on the road, you know, as far as scheduling goes. I guess when I've changed also in the fact that my private time has become a whole lot more precious to me, you know. I mean, it's very, very few and far between the days that I get to get home. And I was gone for almost 8 months this year and was home for 10 days, like one day here, 2 days here, through that. And so those days are really precious, because that's the only time Michelle and I get to spend together, really, except when she'll fly out or down on the road.
Don't you know I'm anxious to see where
With his fourth single, Why Don't That Telephone Ring, still on the charts, Tracy's been putting the finishing touches on his second album, tentatively titled No Ordinary Man, a song he wrote and used to sing at Cutter's.
Tell me about this new album. You just got back from Nashville putting the finishing touches on it. How's it going to come out?
It's great. I'm so happy with it. You know, I think it's going to be hopefully one of, I think it'll be one of those albums that they compare all the rest of my albums to, because I really think it's just chock full of grade A songs and hits, you know, and it's real. It's different from my last album in that it covers a more vast kind of spectrum of what I like to do. You know, I mean, it's got a little stuff that's a little rocking and hard driving like we like to do in concert, and yet it's still got the real country stuff on it too. And I think it's just, I can't wait to get it out, because I think it's gonna stand on its own when it gets out.
With the new album, there'll be more videos, something Tracy likes a lot. His wife, Michelle, is proud of her role in the Someone to Give My Love To video.
Has she been in any other videos?
Yes, she's actually was in Why Don't That Telephone Ring, the recent one, but you don't see anything but her silhouette. They needed someone to sit in the back of the taxi cab when it comes back to the house, and so she was sitting in there. But she did a great job in Someone to Give My Love To, and she kids around with me, says that's her video. She acts like it's, should say Michelle Bird at the end of it instead of Tracy Bird, but she did a great job.
Later this year, Tracy branches out with his film acting debut in a George Lucas thriller called Radioland Murders. He plays Rex Ryder, a singing cowboy who sings, what else, back in the saddle again. But don't expect to lose him to Hollywood anytime soon.
It was a whole lot of fun, but I hadn't seen enough of the serious, in-depth acting to see if I'd like it or not. And right now, still, you know, entertaining and being on stage is tops for me. And I think it'll always stay like that. I don't think it'll ever change, because that's just the one place that I escape from it all, man. I mean, I'm just at ease and enjoying everything that I'm doing, and getting satisfaction from the audience. That's the whole key, I believe. You know, it's the applause that we feed off of, and I think that that'll always be number one in my heart.
And what's his favorite type of song?
As far as a singer, you know, I like to perform ballads better, you know, because usually they're more dynamic as vocally as far as the range goes, you know. And I think as far as a challenge, you know, and singing, those are my favorite ones to sing. But in the show, man, you got to have that high energy, and I get a lot of satisfaction out of us just pumping something, you know, up-tempo song and seeing the people get into it and really get to rocking with us. And so that makes it, you know, those are satisfying too. But as far as a singer, as far as just singing, yeah, I love to sing ballads more than I do up-tempo stuff.
Okay.
I like to sing anything that's a hit. You
know? You can look for Tracy's new album to be released sometime later this spring, and you can catch his movie role in the Radioland Murders later this year.
When we come back, the newest Beaumont artist to rack up big hit songs on the country music charts, Clay Walker.
Living right, living in this little old town I grew up in. But I still held on to my dream. Standing proud, standing tall, standing smack dab in the middle of it all. I don't worry about things that I can't change. And I don't want to think about tomorrow. I don't need anything money can buy. I don't have to beg, steal, or borrow. I just want to live until I die.
It's time to take a ride on the wild side.
Sierra by GMC Truck, the hardest working, best looking truck on the road today.
Texas best.
Rugged, tough trucks that combine comfort and style, plus offer more available engines than any other full-size pickup.
Now that's good looking.
Sierra from GMC, only at your hometown GMC truck dealers.
Time out for the Super Bowl celebration at McDonald's. Every day this week, rush to McDonald's and celebrate with a 99-cent super deal on all your favorite sandwiches. Choose from the world-famous Big Mac, the Quarter Pounder with Cheese, or a Double Cheeseburger, each only 99 cents. Wow, let's see that again. The Big Mac, the Quarter Pounder with Cheese, or a Double Cheeseburger, each only 99 cents. Then add fries and a Coke and sack it. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Mardi Gras, Southeast Texas, is back in downtown Port Arthur, February 11th, 12th, and 13th. A three-day festival of food, fun, music, and parades. Last year, attended by 100,000 people, Mardi Gras, Southeast Texas, has proved to be a family affair, enjoyed by all, young and old alike. If you need additional information on how you or your organization can get involved, contact the Mardi Gras Southeast Texas headquarters at 721-8717. Join the masquerade in downtown Port Arthur, February 11th, 12th, and 13th.
The first time I saw Clay Walker was at the Neon Armadillo here in Beaumont. I couldn't believe that an artist with so much talent was performing here with so little recognition. But Clay had a plan and lots of determination. And in 1993, he saw his dreams begin to come true. In fact, he ended the year with his debut single, What's It To You, finishing at number 3 in the year-end countdown of country music's biggest hit songs.
We need makeup.
Makeup!
In June 1993, a record was released to over 2,000 radio stations in the United States and Canada. Giant Records, a newly formed label in Nashville, had signed a young, good-looking singer from Beaumont, Texas earlier in the year and was looking for their first hit song. Within 3 months, the song What's It To You by Clay Walker had challenged the odds and climbed to the top of the country music charts. ...1993 was a whirlwind year for Beaumont's newest country music star, Clay Walker. In 6 months' time, he had gone from playing at the Neon Armadillo to hundreds of faithful followers to playing for thousands, opening up for superstars like Alan Jackson and George Strait. From June to this January, Clay Walker's accomplishments are incredible. Two number one songs, a gold album, and a nomination for New Male Country Artist of the Year from the American Music Awards. Whenever possible, this rising superstar in country music likes to return home to Beaumont, where we found him writing songs for his next album. Looking back at 1993, what were some of your favorite memories, your highlights of the year 1993?
Man, we had so many. My first record went to number one. You know, that was, I hoped and prayed for that and just kind of didn't even look at the charts, you know. I just kind of put my hands over my face and was hoping that it'd go up to number one. And I remember it, it got up to number two, and we didn't know if it was going to go to number one, and it was just so nerve-wracking.
The door had already been opened by a Beaumont country star who had scored an impressive collection of number one songs.
You know, Mark got it started here for myself and Tracy Byrd, to not give him his due credit would, you know, kind of be robbing him. So I feel like he deserves that credit because he probably, worked harder than as anybody to make it. And I have a lot of admiration for him, for what he's done for Beaumont. He brought the attention here. And I honestly believe without him that things wouldn't have felt like they did for Tracy R.I. as quick. You know, maybe we would have been signed and gotten record deals, but I don't think it would have happened as fast.
What is it about Beaumont? Why are so many country stars coming out of Beaumont?
You know, everybody asks that question all over the world. And I've been all over the United States. We've been up in New York and been as far west as California and different places. And everybody asks, what is it about Beaumont? So that tells me one thing for sure, that Beaumont's on the map, you know. What I tell them is that there's been such a big country music influence here in this area ever since George Jones. You know, George isn't the only one. There was the Big Bopper, who's from here, Janis Joplin. There's all kinds of influences, you know, musical influences. And I think that kind of background gives entertainers, you know, something to go by, some guidelines. I don't necessarily think that you need to imitate or copy anybody, but George definitely set a precedent for country music, all of country music, not just Beaumont. So coming up in his footsteps, all of us younger guys, it's definitely had a big influence on us.
Despite Clay's many accomplishments in a short period of time, it would be unfair to call Clay Walker an overnight success.
Anybody from Beaumont knows that I wasn't an overnight success. I tried for several years, you know, to be successful in Beaumont. And Beaumont's a hard town to be successful in the music industry because there's not a lot of places to play. And it's not Dallas or Houston. It is a small town. Those folks, you know, the folks here that I grew up around all over this area know that I took every gig and that I could work at, you know, took every, played for tips. You know, I started out playing for tips at Cody's restaurant right around here and just played everywhere, did whatever I could do and really wanted it, really wanted the success. But it took a while, you know, for 7 years or 8 years now. I have been trying to be successful at this and playing up in Coma Steel with George Jones. And all of the folks who remember it, that know me do remember, and they know that it didn't come overnight.
Skipping rocks, skipping rope, laughing at all my best friend Joe. Things I loved when I was a kid. Muddy roads, muddy feet. I didn't live on no blacktop street. Things have changed a lot, but I never did.
Your song, Live Until I Die, that's an autobiographical song, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. I grew up right here in Beaumont on a shell road not too far from where we sit right now. And I grew up very in a very rural area where I could had a lot of freedom to run around and hunt, fish, all those good things. And I guess probably my grandmother inspired that song more than anyone else because she taught me, you know, and still teaches me to this day when I go around my grandmother. She doesn't know what a gold album means or, you know, I brought home our gold album. We just went gold for Christmas and she took a look at it and she just smiled real big. And there's only one thing she's concerned about, it's my health. You know, when I walk in, Grandma always looks at me and looks right at my face to see if I've lost any weight or, you know, if I look okay. And always gives me a big hug and a big smile. And there are some lyrics in that song, Live Until I Die. I don't need anything money can buy. I just want to live until I die. And it's that's what I believe.
I don't need anything money can buy. I don't have to beg, steal, or borrow. I just want to live until I die.
In 1992, Clay married Lori Lampson, who joins him much of the time on the road and on his last video. He says having Lori on the road is a blessing.
Being able to spend time with my wife on the road also has been a blessing to me because, you know, I take a look at so many entertainers around me, and I know that they're lonely out there, you know, and it's a rough life. I mean, hell, it's, you know, it's hard to keep going, you know. It's the same old thing day after day. People think, well, it's the life of Riley, and you get to go out there and be in a new town every night, and it's real exciting, and it is to some degree, but you don't get to enjoy it because you're on the bus. You only drive through those states. You don't really get to stop. And having her with me has really inspired me, you know, as encouraged me to keep going.
How has your life changed now that you've had a number one record and top 10 single and you're touring with George Strait?
Well, things are a lot faster now. I travel constantly. Laurie and I both, you know, having my wife with me has definitely helped out a lot, keeping my feet on the ground and keeping my head out of the clouds. So my lifestyle's changed. In 93, well, in 92, I was married, and that changed my life quite a bit. And then in 93, got the record deal. So it was all a gradual change up until that point. And now my life is, my time is more demanded. People demand my time more, and it's it's a comfortable feeling, you know, that people want to do interviews, people want to have autographs, people want me to play at their, in the civic centers or in the clubs, wherever. And Clay hasn't changed very much. You know, I'm still the same. And that's good when I come back home to Beaumont and I see my friends, you know, they all say, man, you haven't changed a bit, and that's exactly how I want it. But my lifestyle's changed quite a bit in the fashion that things are a lot more fast-paced.
And as the pace picks up, so does the caliber of Clay's associates. He's currently working on his next album with two of Nashville's best songwriters.
You know that new song that we just got started, kind of sounds a lot like that. That wind's blowing through you.
Kim Williams and Kent Blasey co-wrote a number of songs with Garth Brooks, and they hope to reach the same success with Clay. Clay Walker continues to climb the ladder of country music success. Truly one of the brightest new stars in country music, he has a message for all of his friends and relatives.
I'm still the same old me.
Clay Walker expects to begin recording that new album in March, with a release date set for August. Clay is competing with John Michael Montgomery and Beaumont's Tracy Byrd for Best New Male Vocalist of the Year award honors at the American Music Awards in February.
Coming up, a look at some of the other highlights from Beaumont's country music year to remember, including a Beaumont-born artist who you may have never heard of, but who scored four top 10 hits in 1993. And later in our show,
tingling, ringing in my head. I woke up dog tired, beat down half dead. Trying to recover from another wild weekend. Chugging down coffee while I should have been sleeping. Well, it sure is Monday, hitting it now. Gotta get myself through the week somehow. I had a ball Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. But it's all over now, and it sure is Monday.
Do you like trucks?
Really like trucks?
Sierra by GMC Truck. American-made quality and value.
Texas best.
Rugged, tough trucks that combine comfort and style.
Now that's a truck I'd like.
Standard 4.3-liter V6 that cranks out 160 horsepower and more available engines than any other full-size pickup.
That's real power.
Sierra from GMC. Only at your hometown GMC truck dealers.
Prices are cheaper at Market Basket. The service is friendlier.
The quality of the merchandise, I like the prices, and I like the cleanliness of Market Basket.
I shop at Market Basket because the prices are reasonable, it's convenient, and they have a wide variety of items that I enjoy.
Prices are great here. I come here all the time and beat my budget right here.
Blame It on Beaumont, a country music year to remember. Brought to you in simulcast by KJC TV4 and KYKR 95.1. Brought to you by Beaumont Regional Medical Center and Market Basket and your hometown GMC truck dealers.
This is a Newswatch 4 update.
Good evening. Results coming in to tonight's viewer poll. The question: should media violence be censored? To vote yes, call 1-900-230-6221. To vote no, call 1-900-230-6222. Results for you coming up tonight at 10. Plus, we will have a report on those results from Nationwide. What are others saying? And another sign, Mardi Gras, Southeast Texas is coming up. That old Bluestein building coming down. I'll see you tonight for the 10 o'clock news.
Play Kicker Radio Lotto. Match five numbers, win $100,000. Listen weekdays, 7:15 a.m. to K95.1. Win $100,000 from KYKR.
Besides Mark, Tracy, and Clay, 1993 has been a significant year for other artists in the Southeast Texas area.
Perhaps one of the greatest country music artists of all, George Jones, enjoyed a comeback with a new album on MCA Records. He also picked up a CMA Award for Vocal Event of the Year with I Don't Need Your Rocking Chair, and his new song, High Tech Redneck, also did well on the charts.
And a Beaumont artist with the most number one songs to his name is probably a name you won't recognize. He was born and raised in Beaumont, graduated from South Park High School, and attended Lamar University.
Country music songwriter Bob McDill. He's written 30 number one songs, including Louisiana Saturday Night and Baby's Got Her Blue Jeans On. In 1993, Bob McDill racked up 4 top 10 hits, 3 of which went to number one.
He says he wants her, can't live without her. Why didn't I think of that? Ooh, I've been watching every move that he makes. Ooh, I've been thinking it could have been different somehow. If I'd known what I know now. On the road where the night is black. On the road where you don't look back. There's a white line in the distance. Where it's going, nobody knows. If it's anywhere, you'll find it.
Beaumont again received national recognition in 1993 when KYKR was the only radio station in America with 3 nominations from the Country Music Association.
KYKR is nominated for Radio Station of the Year. Jimmy, along with his partner in the afternoons, Bill Clark, was nominated for Radio Personality of the Year, as was morning host Gary Lee Love.
We were proud of all of our nominations, but especially Gary Lee Love's win.
Country disc jockeys, yeah! Country DJs are an important part of that great success story, and this year the CMA has chosen the top country DJs, and I get to tell you who they are. Please hold your applause until the end. First, for large markets, the winners are Jim Mantell and Lucy Grant of WGAR Cleveland, Ohio. For medium markets, the winner is Gary Lee Love of KYKR Beaumont, Texas.
Up next, another big winner at the CMA Awards.
After 3 years and 3 albums, Mark Chestnut says now he's really on his way.
You couldn't say it, and I couldn't say it. You know I tried my best to go. I know you cried, but I hurt you so. It should have been easy. Say we were through, but to walk away from love was more than we could do. It was almost goodbye, almost goodbye.
It's time to take a ride on the wild side.
Sierra by GMC Truck, the hardest working, best looking truck on the road today.
Texas best.
Rugged, tough trucks that combine comfort and style, plus offer more available engines than any other full-size pickup.
Now that's good looking.
Sierra from GMC, only at your hometown GMC truck dealers.
Finally, there's a TV show with the latest news on your favorite country stars. If you want to keep up on the latest country videos, TV specials, dance crazes, and concerts from all across the country, join your hosts Lisa Stewart and Dennis Stone each week as they bring you the best and brightest news and information in country music all across America. Be sure and watch Number One Country.
Saturday at 6:30 on KJC. Thursday on KJC-TV4, Brian May and Jeff Schultz will host Sports Watch 4's Willie Ray Smith Senior Award Preview Show. This half-hour program will bring you the highlights of last year's high school football season, recognizing outstanding area high school football players and honoring the memory of an extraordinary man and coach, Willie Ray Smith Senior. Brought to you by Church's Chicken, Payless Plumbing and Supply Company, and Drs. Ronald and Donald Montgomery, DPM. Sports Watch 4's Willie Ray Smith Senior Award Preview Show.
You know the old saying, nothing's free. Well, that's not always true. This is Linda for Starbreak. At Starbreak, we'll give you a free brake check in 10 minutes. Maybe you're going on a trip, or maybe you're just curious as to what your brakes look like. We'll show you your brakes, tell you exactly what it will cost to fix them, and if nothing's wrong, we'll send you on your way. No charge, really. We offer 60 to 90 minute service, pick you up, drop you off. We'll even give you a lifetime warranty. So when you need brakes or you think you need brakes, stop by. It's the best free service you'll ever get. Starbreak, East Texas Lucas. Y'all stop by.
Mark Chestnut grew up in Beaumont, listening to the sounds of George Jones and Hank Williams, and you can hear that influence today in his music, with three albums so far and a fourth one in the works. In 1993, he won his first CMA award, but Mark takes everything in stride. In fact, he gets just as excited talking about the bass ponds on his Jasper Ranch as he does talking about his hit songs. Despite his success, Mark Chestnut has not lost touch with his roots.
And the Horizon Award goes to...
Great company. Mr. Mark Chestnut.
Chestnut.
...1993 was clearly Mark Chestnut's year. After 3 years with MCA Records and 12 hit singles, he finally received the industry recognition he deserved.
Thank you. This is great. I've been watching this show since I was a little bitty kid, and this is the biggest night of my life.
Almost goodbye.
Mark's success was a long time coming. He played the local clubs around Southeast Texas for about 10 years. After a long stint at Cutters, Mark was signed by MCA and his career took off. Despite the successes of his three albums, Mark doesn't consider himself a star. He says he's just a singer.
I can feel your heartbeat as you lay there by my side. I thought of how the world could end.
Mark Chestnut grew up in Beaumont, and when he wasn't singing in a club, he was busy with his other favorite pastimes, hunting and fishing. His love for the outdoors is what keeps him here in Southeast Texas, far from the pressures of Nashville. In 1992, he married Tracy Motley from Winnie. After a six-year courtship, together with their four dogs, they've settled on a ranch in Jasper, where the view alone is breathtaking.
We have 60 acres here and three bass ponds, and so it's beautiful. I love it out here. I can do anything I want to do without leaving my property. I can catch bass, I can hunt deer, and just paradise here. And plus, I'm just about an hour and a half away from saltwater, so I can do some of that too.
To talk with Mark, it's quickly apparent he's just a good old boy. His honesty carries a sense of wit, and his desire for a simple life and good times is obvious. About the only thing that separates Mark from the characters he sings about is perhaps his toys, one that comes in handy after a long time out on the road.
Yeah, a lot of times, being on the road, you know, your schedule is full every day. You have something to do from the time you get up until the time you lay down at night, and it's always go, go, go. And you spend a lot of time in the bus, A lot of time in hotel rooms. You don't get much time to get outside much. Yeah. And so the very first thing I do when we pull up here to this gate is I dump stuff off there in the house and jump on my four-wheeler, and I just tear out across here and ride around for, it don't matter if it's 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, I'll just get out here and ride, just freedom, you know.
Yeah.
Just getting so tired of being cooped up.
We sat down to talk in his living room, decorated with style by his wife, a photography student at Lamar University, who, like Mark, prefers to stay out of the limelight.
We dated, probably about 6 years altogether before we finally decided to get married and get a life, you know, because the first couple years on the road was real tough being gone all the time.
Tell me about the Horizon Award. Was that the highlight of 1993 for you?
Yeah, I was backstage. I just finished doing a little bit of, I guess it was Sure as Monday. Mm-hmm. And after that song, after I finished it, I was real relieved. I said, man, I'm glad that's over. And really didn't think about the award. And then they called out my name. Boy, that was... You could have set my head on fire. I wouldn't have known about it.
What went through your mind as they called your name?
Yeah, it's hard to explain. I really don't know. It was something that I'll never feel that way again. Even if I win, 10 more awards, I won't feel that first way. I just felt like, man, finally, the damn industry realizes that I'm here.
Well, it sure is Monday, hey, ain't it the truth? I partied too hard and now I'm paying my dues. I had a ball Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. But it's all over now and the show is Monday.
Besides the feeling of acceptance brought on by the Horizon Award, the honor has changed the way Mark looks at a few things. He's setting his sights on some more awards down the road.
My name was rarely mentioned, and now with the Horizon Award, it's different now. Now I guess that's because before I won the award, I was just another singer. I just hadn't done anything yet. So you get a lot more recognition. I used to say, I don't care if I win an award or not. You know, that's not what we're in this business for. But that was a big crock of nothing after I won that award. Yeah, this is great. This is what it's all about. It really made me feel like I've done something worthwhile.
Along with Mark's success, there's a little sadness. He lost his father shortly after things began to take off in 1990. Bobby Chestnut also gave Nashville a try, writing and cutting several songs years ago. Mark keeps his father's advice close by.
He always told me to stay the same way, you know. He said, don't change. Just be the same old boy that you were when they found you, and try not to let it all go to your head, because it can end a lot quicker than it started. You know, a career is a very fragile thing these days in the music business. And it looks a lot more solid than it really is, you know, because you're only as good as your last record or your last show. And there's so many new artists out there now that are coming right up just every day behind us. You know, I'm only 30 years old. I feel like an old veteran now.
While Mark may feel like a veteran, he takes a different approach to the music business than some do, preferring to surround himself with people from the outside.
I don't think it's intentional, but a lot of people in Nashville, a lot of artists end up writing songs and performing for the industry, for the other artists and the other musicians there in Nashville. And I think when that happens, they lose touch with what's really going on in the real world out here, you know. Like people, my friends that I've been hanging out with for years, they don't know anything about writing a song. They don't know anything about the business, and they're not interested in that. But they know what they like and what they don't like when they listen to that radio. They know what they're going to go out and buy. And they know who they're going to go see in concert. And I like to stay in touch with that. I like to hang out with people who work every day, have a normal job, and they can tell me pretty much what they like and why. And so hanging out in Nashville a lot, people have a tendency to pat you on the back and pat themselves on the back and tell you how great you are. Oh, that's a great song. They use that word a lot in Nashville. That great and incredible. Oh, that's great. That's incredible. Well, they might think so, but people here in Southeast Texas who work at the refineries, you know, they might not think it's so great or incredible. So I like to talk to them and find out the truth.
Mark's shyness doesn't keep him away, however, when it comes to a good cause. This year, he co-chairs Country AIDS Awareness with Mary Chapin Carpenter. They've launched a series of public service announcements with the theme, Breaking the Silence.
People in the country music industry can talk to a whole different bunch of people out there, because I know a lot of my friends, they don't listen to what Madonna or Liz Taylor or those people have to say. Listen to Garth Brooks or George Strait or even me. Yeah. Hopefully.
For folks to listen, Mark's got to talk, and that's still something he prefers not to do too much of. At a recent meeting in Washington, he was put on the spot.
We didn't know we had to talk. We thought we just had to be there, be present. And we had to talk. I think there were like 12 different things going on that day, programs, and we had to talk at each one. God, that was terrible.
Terrible. Why is that hard? You just don't like to...
Well, first of all, I didn't like anybody there in D.C. that I had to talk to. You know,
<That's>
I disagree with everything they say. So,
goodbye. It was all.
Took a long break over the Christmas holidays, but he's heading back into a hectic schedule. He'll be headlining his own concert dates this year, with the exception of a few dates with Wynonna Judd. In between, he's also working on his fourth album.
Yeah, we started work on the fourth album back in December, and we got four songs cut, but we're not sure if we're going to use anything. That's how we usually do this thing. We'll get in the studio and work on it for 4 or 5 months and end up cutting 15 songs and only using 10 for the album. So, the four we've cut so far, you know, we were all pretty excited about them at first. That after we got in there and recorded them, I don't know. We're going back in later this month, and then I'll finish the album probably in April. It should be out sometime after that.
With 1994 gearing up to be another busy and successful year for Mark Chestnut, he expects 1993 will always be his year to remember.
You know, we've had 3 great years. We've been really, really lucky to have all 12 singles go to at least 5, you know. And that'll always stand out, but 93 will be remembered for the year I got my first CMA award.
With the country music spotlight currently shining on Beaumont, Mark says he's flattered when credited with opening the doors for Tracy Byrd or Clay Walker, but he's quick to add that they've made it on their own. And what advice does he have for other up-and-comers?
I know if I lived in some other part of the country and if I was trying to get started in a business, I would move to Beaumont pretty quick.
As Mark said, he's currently finishing up that album, his fourth for MCA Records, and he expects to have it out later this year.
We'll be back after this.
Wait till you hear what's on Hot Hippin' Country. One of the hottest, the hippest, the country's music shows you'll ever want to see. And we'll give you more country than you can handle. Ooh, our Hot Hippin' Country dancers use moves you won't see anywhere else. Join us every week for Hot Hippin' Country.
Hot Hippin' Country, Saturdays at 6 on KJC.
Hello, I'm Micah from Del Papa Distributing. Budweiser is the official sponsor of the Majestic Crew of Aurora Grand Parade, Saturday, February 11th at 6 p.m. 20 floats with riders in magic-themed costumes will provide a beautiful and exciting nighttime lighted parade. Traditional beads, cups, and doubloons will be thrown to spectators. I'm Heather Dornbos here with my friends. St. Mary Hospital is proud to be the official sponsor of the Munchkin Parade on February 13th. The Munchkin Parade is for little ones ages 3 to 10. A $2 registration fee is charged and children must be in costume. A basket of throws will be provided for each participant. To enter, please call St. Mary Hospital or the Mardi Gras office.
Hi, I'm Dr. Lynn Myers, the South Jefferson County Veterinary Medical Association, the official sponsor of the first ever Pet Parade on February 13th. The Pet Parade is for dogs, cats, and pigs in costumes, of course. Contact your vet for entry or the Mardi Gras office on Highway 365. Come join the fun.
Thursday on KJC-TV4, Brian May and Jeff Schultz will host SportsWatch 4's Willie Ray Smith Senior Award Preview Show. This half-hour program will bring you the highlights of last year's high school football season, recognizing outstanding area high school football players and honoring the memory of an extraordinary man and coach, Willie Ray Smith Senior. Brought to you by Church's Chicken, Payless Plumbing and Supply Company, and Drs. Ronald and Donald Montgomery, DPM. SportsWatch 4's Willie Ray Smith Senior Award Preview Show.
With the successes of Mark Chestnut, Tracy Byrd, and Clay Walker, the national spotlight shining on Beaumont continues to grow. In fact, Billboard magazine recently ranked Beaumont number 3 on its list of country music hotspots.
So the next time you're out dancing here at Cutter's, or at Phase 2, the Longhorn Club, or Bourbon Street, keep in mind that the band you see on stage could be the next act signed to a major recording label.
A number of recording officials are currently keeping an eye on Beaumont's George Dearborn, who performs right here on the Cutter's stage.
Brad Brinkley, Kerry Stone, and the River Road Band are some other local names to keep your eye on.
And just as 1993 was a country music year to remember for Mark, Tracy, and Clay, it'll be exciting to see how 1994 shakes out.
Well, that just about brings our show to an end, Mark.
It does. It's been a lot of fun. We hope that you folks at home have enjoyed watching it as much as we've enjoyed putting it together. Thanks for being with us.
Good night.
Well, I know my number's in the book. Why don't the telephone ring? Don't you know I'm anxiously waiting, longing for her long-distance call? I wish I knew what her silence is saying.
Skipping rope, laughing at all my best friend Joe. Things I loved when I was a kid. Muddy roads, muddy feet. I didn't live on no blacktop street. Things have changed a lot, but I never did. And I don't wanna think about tomorrow. I don't need anything money can buy. I don't have to beg, steal, or borrow. I just wanna live until I die. Oh, I got to the job site at a 9:15. And somehow I stayed awake till lunchtime. And then I caught a little nap stretched out in my truck bed. My feet still twitching to the music in my head. Well, it sure is Monday, ain't it the truth? I